Hi, my name is Lana. Welcome back to my channel. So earlier this month, I did a video where I showed you my Bojo setup for January 2021. I showed you my usual setup and stuff like that. And I did mention that in the back, I had plans to do like maybe a reading journal or something. So a few weeks have passed and I did add certain things in like the first half of the journal and also set up several, let's say, bookish pages. So if you watched my last video, you probably remember some of the setup that I did, added all the like cheat sheet information on each moon phase. So today is Monday, that's when I'm filming, and it's the last week of January. And so I've already made the like intro page for February, which I'm very proud of. I've never used sort of like scrap paper things for my bullet journal, and this is actually parchment for baking. I don't think I will be using this again just because it was a lot of effort, and I mean it looks great. Probably not something I would consistently use, but as I was preparing my February setup, I wanted to fill in this like last page of the month and what did I want to include in it. So if you remember, each week I do like a good week, bad week, where I write like the best thing that happened that week and like the worst thing that happened that week. And so I thought I would do a good month, bad month, where I would just look through the good weeks and the bad weeks that happened that month and just pick the one, like the best thing and the worst thing, I guess. Then I have a favorite book and worst book. I don't love using the word worst book, but this would mean, you know, the book I enjoyed the most and the book I enjoyed the least. And then I also want to start tracking growth on my channels. So I included YouTube and Instagram, where I would write subscriber count and follower count, just to keep track. And also added an achievement place where I would write anything that I felt proud for doing that month. And then continues on the usual way. And so again, just to reiterate, this kind of setup for every month and then weekly pages would continue on up till here December would end, and I would have like two pages to, I don't know, review the year maybe. And then I did wish list, which are like things that I would like to invest my money in, things I would like to buy, gift ideas. I covered this up because you don't need to see this again. Like family members or friends, when I think of what would be a good gift for them. And I think this is like enough space to include everything. Obviously, this will be filled in more and more throughout the year. Then I have an affirmations page. Again, I'm leaving space because I like to think that I will find some awesome new affirmations that I could use this year. Then I have movies to watch and TV to watch. Also like movies and TV shows that I just want to remember that I'm interested in them, because I easily forget these things. And this is sort of like a tracker of my videos on YouTube. There is no like specific goal for this. I'm just interested to see what pattern emerges. So these are the months of the year and the days, and in the blue are videos that I've posted on my channel. And I don't have like a set schedule for my videos. I usually think like a week ahead, but sometimes not even that. And I'm not really looking to set like a strict schedule, but this gives me a good idea like how much time has passed since my last video. And if I do film ahead, I kind of can see like how many days do I want to go between the videos and stuff like that. Again, this is just an experiment. I'm curious to see if there is a pattern and if maybe this will help me find a schedule that works for me. I don't know. In the end here, there is a T for total, where I would write the total number of videos I posted that month. Then again, YouTube, Instagram, at how many subscribers and followers I had at the beginning of that month. Maybe I will find like a link between how many videos I post and how many more subscribers I get. I don't know. I'm not really taking YouTube or Instagram super seriously, I have to say. I don't really have a goal for how many subscribers I want and stuff like that. That's you know, I'm not looking to ever make this like a full-time career for myself. This is definitely hobby, but the amount of effort it takes to be on Bookstagram and film these videos and edit them and put them up, it is a lot of work. Even though I'm not making any money off of this, anything like that, I think seeing like the growth in numbers would be a sort of like return from my work. Like it will feel good to see it and motivate me to continue. I mean, I've been doing this less than a year, so I don't know. I'm just trying things out here. Next, I have all the physical unread books on my shelves, and I've decided to give each month a different color. That way, when I, for example, blue is for January, so that way when I read books off of my like unread shelves in January, I mark them in blue and stuff like that, so I can see in each month how well I did, I guess. And so like, yes, these are all the books that I had unread on my shelves before the new year, and the two books that I've bought since. Then if you remember my reading challenges video, I decided to go with the unread shelf project. And that one is all about minimizing the amount of unread books you have on your shelves. And I've already, as you can see, read 4 books off of my shelf this year, which I think is great. And hopefully I will complete this bingo board by the end of the year. Next, I have all the unread ebooks that I own. And ever since I've done this list, I actually have 2 or 3 more that I bought. So I will have to include them. I decided to group them by genre, because then if I am in the mood to read something, I'm usually in the mood for a specific genre. So I would, you know, oh, I want to read a romance. Okay, here are my choices for romance, stuff like that. Hopefully this will make it easier for me. Next one is a little bit of like a workstation for me. So here we have the buddy reads that are happening this year. So in pen, I'm writing all the ones that are happening for sure. In pencil, ones that I'm pretty sure are happening. And then on this post-it, I have all the maybes, the like plans that were not confirmed with different booktubers on buddy reads and stuff. This one is just like a little reminder that I want to read 8 Perfect Murders, and I decided to read the 8 books that are mentioned in that book before I get to it, and so it's like a reminder that that's something I want to do. On this page, I have the readathons, and again, in pen, I will put readathons that I've taken part in so far, just 1 this year. And on this post-it, I have written those that I would like to participate in this year, so I don't forget about them. And this little thing came out of my collaboration with Milena from Milena Reads. We did 2 awesome videos. If you haven't seen them, definitely check them out. We played quizzes and different bookish games, and when we were planning those videos, we did have like a video call when we talked about different options that we could do, and in that time I just came up with so many different ideas. I did a lot of research on what other people have done on YouTube, and these are like the main ideas that came out of that research, and we definitely picked some of these. We didn't do others, and I would like to do more collaborations with other booktubers, and so I think like this is a good cheat sheet of like what could we do. I also want other people to do these, so I'm not like, this is not secret information. You can pause and look at it. I mean, have fun deciphering my handwriting, but I like to have options. Next up are my video ideas. These are a lot. What I want to primarily talk about is these 3 things that I came up with that I'm so proud of. So I get tagged in book tags, and I find it hard to keep track of them. Thankfully, so far it's been fine, but I've decided that every time I would get tagged or I would find a tag that I want to do, I'd write it on this little post-it, and when I did all of them, I would just get rid of it and start anew so as not to take a lot of space. Then I have similar ones for book haul and ebook haul. This one has nothing on it because I just filmed a book haul, and that's kind of what I want to do. Every time I buy a book, I will write it down here, and when I have like enough to, you know, do a video on, I will take it off and use it for a video and then start anew. Same thing with ebooks. I will do an ebook haul soon, and then just ideas that I would like to do or things that I'm already doing, like monthly finds or like stuff like my all-time favorite books, a video that I'm terrified to do because I would have to make the impossible choice, and I've already like started writing things down in pencil but I'm not sure, and stuff like that. So yeah, and this is it for now. I still have quite a few pages left after this, which I like the option of writing more things if I do think of other like trackers or something that I would want to write down in this journal. I'm very proud of how like compact everything is. So yeah, this is my like reading journal setup, I guess. Oh no, it came off. Anyway, thank you so much for watching. I hope this was interesting to you. I will see you in my next video.